completely is I would tell them, continue to do what you do. If you see things that are concerning, push them up to local law enforcement immediately. If they rise to a certain level, or if you want to push it to both the FBI and local law enforcement, feel free to do that. These are your protectors.
Sister, what do you
think? But do as you do normally. Go about your day. Do not let this cause mass hysteria. We're not there. We're not there at all. We have a long-term, very complex investigation that we have to complete. And that's going to take time and a lot of energy and a lot of hours and a lot of agency expertise. But I assure the American public, we will do everything in our power within the law to get that done. Thank you for your time. Next, I would like to introduce Sheriff John McMahon.
Thank you, Dave.
The FBI
very good
has
question,
confirmed.
And that's why we're here today.
Active terrorism.
My primary responsibility and the primary responsibility of the law enforcement leaders you see behind me is to ensure the safety of the public that we serve. You've already heard there's apparently evidence to suggest that there is a terrorist connection to this event. We have no known credible threats to the communities that we serve. I would ask that the community remain vigilant. Don't hesitate to report any suspicious activity to the local law enforcement. We have added additional resources, as had my partners from law enforcement that stand behind me, to ensure that we have the staff necessary to investigate and to protect the communities that we serve. We have nothing to suggest there's anything additional associated with this event, but we remain partnered up with the law enforcement from the FBI, ATF, Homeland Security, and that if any threats come about that appear to be credible or not, we will fully investigate those to help ensure that the public that we serve is absolutely safe. I will echo what Dave Bowditch suggested, that this is a team effort. We all have to work together as a team to address situations of this magnitude. We remain committed to working with the FBI, our local partners, as well as our federal partners, to ensure that the resources that are needed are applied to make sure we investigate everything possible and keep the citizens that we serve safe. Thank you.
Sheriff, you're concerned, though, that there was no credible threat or no credible threat in advance, and then this occurred, and so now we're back to an environment where there's no known credible threat, and could San Bernardino or any other town in the country be facing the same kind of thing happening an hour from now?
Certainly that's the possibility, but crimes across our county and across our state oftentimes occur without any notice. You saw how the men and women of this law enforcement agency, as well as the partners that we work with in our region, performed 2 days ago. Considering how they performed and addressed the issue, I truly believe that we are prepared to deal with whatever threat or incident occurs. Law enforcement is staffed up, as I suggested. Our local law enforcement leaders remain in constant contact with one another, and as I suggested, my top priority, as well as those that stand behind me, is the safety of the public that we serve. Thank you.
Sheriff, the town home. Redlands Chief, you have jurisdiction over the town home and have you sealed the town home.
Looks like they're going to wrap it up here now. The city of San Bernardino, California is the scene of the latest terrorist attack on the United States of America committed by Islamic extremists. That's not my opinion anymore. That's the view of the Federal Bureau of Investigation. Big, big press conference just wrapping up in San Bernardino, and that's a game changer. Like I said, every major network, immediately when they heard those words, act of terrorism, broke in to their programming to make that announcement. 14 people dead in San Bernardino, of all places. San Bernardino, California. Would you have expected that would be the next terrorist attack? It's the biggest, most significant terrorist attack in this country since 9/11, with 14 lives lost.
Wow.
Let me just, before I break here, talk about what that actually means in technical terms, because a lot of the reporters are asking about...